Hello, everybody. My name is Mathis, and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. We're back at Firelink Shrine, actually, and there's a reason for that. I forgot to show you guys a couple of things, something that I just didn't even, like, click with me for some reason or another, and that is actually, we're at the top of Firelink Shrine, as you can see. I walked all the way up the stairs, and for some reason, I just blanked on coming up here and showing you this. There is something interesting up here. Minorly interesting, however, but still, it's interesting nonetheless. There's a little outpost out here that kind of hints that there's more around than what we've seen. We got some graves up here that overlook the area that we were at prior. Ooh, no, there's more stuff down there. I missed out on that. We'll have to go take a look, but moreover, this is a giant. Made prevalent initially in Dark Souls 2. A seed of a giant tree is yet to fall. I don't know what this means. A giant tree. But it is in the shape of a giant, like from Dark Souls 2, which is crazy. And then up here, we have a ladder that we can kick down at some point. I wonder how we could get that. There's got to be a way. And then there's some items up here. So there's plenty of exploration that I just missed up here that I meant to check out. So this is locked. Let's see. Is anything over here? No. All right. Let's keep looking around. Like I said before, I am going to be taking this playthrough much, much more slowly than I do most things, because I do want to kind of explore, and I feel silly that I forgot this area over here. A homeward bone. Wait, wasn't I over here? Try jumping. How about no, we don't try jumping. Nothing down there, so why would I do that? No, sir. No, sir, will not be trying jumping. Thank you, though. Appreciate it. Appreciate the tip. And then over here, there is more. So there is much more to this Firelink Shrine than I initially anticipated. That I just missed out on. An ember. Alright. I hear a fire going. And there's a guy just napping. Yeah, that's where we came from. Okay, let's try this. This guy just, like, started a fight, apparently. Alright, let's try. I don't know how he died. He must have been, like, really, really hurt and fucked up. Okay. Sweet. I've not been here. This is very confusing. Did I really miss all of this? I am mad at myself. I knew of that area up there, but I didn't really kind of pan out and look anywhere else. So that's Firelink Shrine. Time for joy. Hey, that's my message. Alright, let's see. What did I miss over here? Is there anything else that I missed or not? Oh, there's a dude up there. Hello, sir. You just, are you like, can I talk to you? Nope, you are gonna attack me. You have a huge fucking sword, actually. You are not also like one of the undead either. Ooh. Ooh! Oh, he parried me! Holy shit! No, get out! Drink. Okay, he parried me. That's confusing as hell. Oh my god, he barely takes any fucking damage. Okay. Maybe the edge is like what I need to do. Oh god damn it. Okay. Let's try this. Let's back up. Oh, there's something in that tree there. Okay, alright, well. Oh, fuck. Can I get behind him? I can't even. Can he? I'm assuming if he can parry, he can also knock my shield out. Oh my god. What is he guarding that's like so important? Alright. This is ridiculous. I did not expect this. I hit him. I'm happy. Ooh, Jesus. Okay. He has like nothing on, which is really. What's confusing? This guy's like a lone fucking samurai warrior. And I don't have a lot of stamina here. Oh god, oh, I'm dead. I'm gonna die. Gotta get my stamina up. I'm so glad I have a fucking shield right now. Okay. No, I'm dead. Alright, we're coming back. Holy shit. Oh my god. Okay. This is really interesting. Who is this guy? Why is he at Firelink Shrine? Why is he guarding Firelink, like something at Firelink Shrine too? I didn't have a lot of souls to lose, so I'm not too concerned about the soul loss if I end up dying before that. But yeah, okay, up there. I'm still very curious as to what the fuck is going on. Who is this man? Alright, so, one of the things this game does is, it puts fog walls up here because it's like loading. So I kind of have to wait for the loading to happen before I can go out, which is a shame. Where am I? I've actually lost myself. Oh, it's on the other side. Whoops. I was like, wait a minute, why is it not here? Oh, wait, it's over here. God, man. Holy crap. Dude has no armor, but he has this giant sword and just, like, destroys me. His attack pattern seems relatively, like, manageable. What makes him really tough is that I'm kind of fighting him on this narrow path, of which he clearly has an advantage of, and he's super dexterous and nimble, so a little bit difficult, but I'm definitely gonna keep fighting him. At least a few more times if I can't get him now, but I'm gonna have to clear out the trash first. Oh god, don't get hit here. It'd be a waste of health that you badly will need. Yeah, at 1,000 souls, it's decent. Hey dude, listen, I wanna be friends. Here, let's leave a message. Templates. Be wary of... Can I put just like ninja? Critical foe. Just going to put that down for people. Here he comes. He's doing that fucking... Ooh, shit. Okay, he's going to do that thing. Going to try and draw it out of him. Oh, there it is again. Dodge back. Get my stamina. And he inflicts bleed. Yeah, I know. I got an Estus in. Sorry, buddy. Oh, God. Okay. Okay. Do not fall off the edge. Good roll. All right. Rolling is going to be the key to this fight, I really think, because he hits so hard that it's not worth it for me. Oh god, oh god, roll! 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 Fish can roll! Drink. Alright, we gotta get the fuck back here. Maybe fight him over here. Ah, man. Just gonna swing around a bunch and maybe get behind him. Okay. Spinning around him when he's doing that weird thing. Seems to be... Ow. He got me? He whipped around! Holy god. Alright. Lord almighty, how are we gonna do this? I think spinning around him is gonna be my tactic. Again, the problem with the fight... It's not a problem. It's just me being bad. But the difficulty comes in the form of the narrow fighting arena. But... I want to kill him, man. I absolutely must kill him. I want to know. Other side. Okay, so what are we thinking? We could try and do it like that and just worry about dodge rolling. It's a possibility. Might not be a good idea, clearly, because I'm not doing a great job fighting him, but we'll see. If you heard a grinding noise, that was me messing with my headphones there. I apologize. Go kill the trash and pick up our souls. Again, it's at least relatively like punishment free, which is nice. I'm trying to think. I could fight him down here if we scout out the area. I mean, there's a good amount of room over here I could fight him in. I don't know if he'll back out. I think I can fish him. I think I can fish him all the way over there though. I want to know what he's protecting. He's protecting a door. He's kind of just standing there. coming? Come on. I'm gonna drag your ass all the way down here, man. You scare me a little bit with how, like, slow and plodding you're being. Come on. Down here. I'm gonna fish you all the way down here, sir, I promise. Ugh. He still inflicts bleed through the block, which is insane. Mm. Don't get hit, man. Down. Come on, follow me down here, dude. Okay, I'm gonna die. Back up. First Estus, at least. Beautiful. Got a backstab. Good. And we got a couple of hits in. So a backstab is gonna do me a lot of favors. I gotta get out. Oh, shit. He almost fell off the edge. Yep. Understandable. I'd back out, too, if I just got my ass fucking handed to me like that. There's the third attack, which will break my shield down for the most part. Okay. I think we can do this. Third time's the charm. Okay. I think we've got it this time. Got him. Whew! Dude, you attacked first. Uchi Katana, Master's Attire, Master's Gloves. What in God's name is Master's Attire? A terribly worn shirt. Men are fond of weaving tales to explain the raggedness of their garb. My sixth sense warned me of danger, and I danced between flurries of blades unscathed, but alas, my clothes went to tatters. So he's dodged so much that no blade touched his body, but it destroyed his clothing. Terribly worn. My sixth sense warned me of danger, and I danced around. Yeah. That doesn't look like it's got too much cuts going on it, though. So poison and curse resist. It's good for magic and, like, dancing around. Moreover, we got a katana. A unique katana characterized by the fine craftsmanship of an eastern land where it was forged. The finely shaped blade cuts flesh like butter and causes bleeding but breaks easily as a result. Skill hold. Assume a holding stance to rapidly execute a lunging slash with normal attack or a deflecting parry with a strong attack. I have an X on it, however. I don't think I can wield it right now. I need more strength. I have the dexterity. I just need more strength. Interesting. I like it. So, more importantly, what in God's name was he protecting up here? A door to where? It does not open from this side. Is it a grave? From here, it looks like he's protecting a grave of some sort. The question is, how do I get in there? Yes, sir. Trust me. I understand the deaths here. Yes. I am very, very interested and intrigued as to what the hell that's all about. All right. Let's grab this. East-West Shield. A wooden shield decorated with ancient symbol of two-headed eagle close to a small shield in size. Wooden shields are light, manageable, and offer relatively high magic absorption. Skill parry. Repel an attack at the right time to follow up a critical hit. Works with equipped weapons in hand. Also, I'm curious. Does this have a skill? While in stance. I don't know what in stance means. Use normal attack to break a foe's guard from below or strong attack to get it upward. I don't know what getting in stance means. I'm going to have to learn what that means. Because I'm clicking. I don't know what that does. All right, let's look around for a little bit. Because I haven't been down here. I don't think I've been down here. I mean, oh no, I definitely have been down there. Yeah, that's where I came from. Okay, cool. Noted. Let's swing down here And we got our 3,000 souls, so we might be able to level up. So let's see if she's willing to level me up.
Welcome home, Ashen One.
Thanks.
Speak thine heart's.
Let's level up.
Then touch Hagen.
Okay. Yes, I can. I think I'm gonna pop it into strength.
Okay. Ashen One.
So let's take a look. Can I wield it now? No. Oh, I need a 16 dex. I need dex. I'm an idiot. I don't know why I was looking at that. I need dex, not strength. All right, well, that's fine. We put another point into strength. It's not a big deal. We're going to head back to the High Wall of Lothric, where we ended last episode, and do a little exploration. Honestly, I'm not even that mad. I'm happy I came across it. We died two or three times to him? Not too bad. All right, High Wall of Lothric, where we already lit a bonfire. And now where we have options. So, we have a dead dragon over there. I don't see anything over here, though we can look around and make 100% sure. Is this an illusionary wall? No, it is not. I hear groaning. And we can see here, like, corpses that have become trees. And there's, like, goop on them. And they're reaching out, it looks like, to the sky, if that means anything. Are they reaching out to the kingdom? That must be Lothric. I mean, we're in the High Wall of Lothric, so that must be Lothric. And then over here, we have some dudes and some dogs. Let's venture down here for a minute and see if we can maybe pull this dog. Oh, there's a couple dogs. There's one all the way over there. That's fine. One dog at a time. I prefer it that way. That guy looks way more war-torn. This dog looks way worse off. Yeah. I know. Come on. Ow. Bad damage. It's okay. So there's that guy over there. And then there's like a... Huh? Okay. I heard him. I heard like the fumbling of like somebody coming over here. Yeah, I knew you were going to do that. Okay, move. Good dodge. I like to kill you off before your friend gets close. It's another guy with another axe. Or halberd of some type. I hear moaning. Oh, shit. I forgot that this was up here. So, before we worry about that, there's an asshole that likes to chill up here. That I can get rid of. Just hang there, bud. Don't worry. Now, can I get a plunging attack? No. Nope, and I'm gonna get hit in the process. It's down Estus. Waste of an Estus, in my opinion, but it's fine. Let's see if we can get behind him. Beautiful. Finish you off, and then... Good. Cleared up. Alright. Slow and steady wins the goddamn race. Now, before I go over there, I'm curious, is there anything over here? Nope, I can't even get over there. So who is patrolling down there? And there's something up there. Well, we might as well check out the closest stuff first. All kinds of statues with candles, it looks like. So maybe worshiping the light in some way. Is there somebody here? Oh, hey, what's up? Thought I heard the moaning. Well, let's see what's going on down this area. Ooh, a door. That guy looks like he's napping. Yeah, that's what I thought. You looked like you were taking a nap. Indeed you were, just relaxing. Okay. Does not open from this side. Alright, so there's gotta be another way over there. Now, mind you, I have played through this area, but again, because I was mostly doing just test recordings, I didn't really explore a ton. So if it sounds like some things are confusingly or new to me, it's because I probably glazed over it during my test recordings. Easy enough. Oh, shit. Hey! So, there's some enemies that transform in this game. We are finding them right now. Dodge. They are very much abyss-like from the first boss that we fought. Very similar in transformation. move. We're gonna have to pop an Estus here. Oh my god, he destroyed my fucking shield. Luckily, he's only a 3-hit combo. Oh god, I'm gonna die. I gotta get out. Last Estus already. Oh god, move! Come on. Whew! I have never killed that thing before. Ember and a Titanite Shard. I have no idea if that will respawn or not. My gut says yes, it probably will, but I don't know. That sucked. That was... When I first saw him up here, I assumed that I was... I just ran. I assumed I would just lose, and I ran. So... That is... This is all new. I have not really been able to explore here before. I don't know if I can. Alright, was it just... That's it? That's all that's up here? Looking to see if there's any secrets. Doesn't look like it. I'm surprised I don't see a ton of bloodstains. Just one. This guy is... Look like he's playing the warrior class. Those things are... That's not... There's another one that we're gonna have to fight relatively soon that's not too far away. So don't worry. That's gonna be a good time. Alright, so this is all just a dead end then. But we got, we did get a bow that we can equip and we can use. So in fact, let's take a look at the bow. Longbow commonly used by hunters. Arrows must be equipped in order to use bows. Yeah. So what we're gonna have to do is click this and we can put it here. And then automatically equipped our arrows for us. And when we switch to that, we can do it now. Is that a fat roll? I can't tell. Nope, it's the same. Well, actually, let's unequip that. It feels like a fat roll. But maybe not. Okay. Good. We're going to go ahead and refill our Estus right here. Thank God, man. Thank God that was what we were able to do. That made it a lot better. Okay. Let's continue. So down here is another alleyway we can kind of explore. A little bit less difficult from what I remember, but the problem being... We're going to come across our first real annoying enemy. Not that that thing that we just fought wasn't annoying. But what you'll see is... See that guy up there? Right down there with the lamp? What he does, he doesn't fight. That asshole doesn't fight. He just sounds the alarm and wakes up a bunch of dicks. That we have to, he tries to basically swarm us. So what I'm gonna have to do is charge him and just go like that. Now, it looks like we got him before he was able to wake up the assholes, which is good. It means we can kind of come around here and just clear out these guys for free souls. Not that they give us much. 30 souls for the two. Ooh, Titanite Shard. Titanite Shard, wow. That is very, very lucky. I'm very happy about that. That is the first time that's happened to me. So these guys, all worshiping a dead dragon that seems to just be flaking away in front of us, as you can see. Is that a skull? Probably not, but this is just a dead dragon lying here, just chilling. And that's not gonna be the first dead dragon in the area either. I think there's a second one. Not too far. Right. So there's another guy over there that sounds the alarm. He's attacking the chair. I'm just gonna kill him off quickly because inside there are two dudes with like guards. Basically, any of these guys that have like a weird light around them, you can typically assume are gonna take a couple of hits and are like hollowed out soldiers. Okay. Kill them off. Everybody else is relatively easy. Just one hit, one kill. And then I think up here... Yeah, there's a dick. There's a couple of dicks. Oof, bad swing. Always let them attack first if you can't see him. But another easy kind of just wipe out. And then we can... Binoculars. Which is neat. I tried using them up here. There's really not much to see. But there's, like, you can kind of just see Lothric out in the distance. And the draw distance is really nice. Like, if we come over here and take a look, I don't think there's much. Like, we can kind of look over the edge, but I don't. We're going to be going down that area soon enough. Yeah, we're going to be going down there in a minute. All right, let's keep moving. I don't want to say rapidly, but we're kind of quickly approaching the area in which I go blind and not really know what's going on. Like I said, I only played for about an hour, hour and a half, so. Mostly, again, just trying to put my computer through its paces, make sure it can record fine. Let's just kill you off, and then there's another guy chilling over here. Again, they're not trying to hide too much, but if you come over here like you're supposed to and be like, oh, hey, what's this? Firebomb. Oh, hey. Classic Dark Souls ambush situation where there's guys just sitting there waiting for somebody. And then you come through here and, hey, how's it going? How's things? All right, you have a good day. Have a good one, buddy. And then, oh, right. So there's this little, I don't want to say a secret, but there is an item over there we can get. Can I come under the dragon? No. Not like that, anyway. But yeah, if we loop around over here. Yo, I saw your arm move. Yeah, we can swing out this way. Trying to mitigate a little bit of the fall damage. Gold pine resin. Classic. Alright, let's come down here. I'm trying to remember if this is where I want to go. I think so. I know this is the definitive, like, progress to the next area route, but I want to make sure that I'm not missing anything optional. I feel like I am. I don't know why. Oh, hey. Well, I missed you, clearly. And you. Yeah, I think I've seen everything I need to. Because I've gone up there, got the binoculars. Okay. Alright, so this is a relatively trying part of the area that I recall. So we come over here, and we're going to be introduced to our first real kind of obstacle. Come out here. Hello? What I'm going to do is actually come up these stairs, because as soon as I do, sniper spot. Yep, there he is. All right, see you later. Dragon. We all remember what happened to the dragon in the first Dark Souls. It's the same fucking thing. He looks all fucked up, though, doesn't he? Yeah, all right. Swing out here. He's going to do a giant scream, and we're going to back the fuck out, and he's just going to breathe fire everywhere. We can kind of see what the radius of that attack is, and this guy was not affected, so that's good to know. But every time he screams, it's fire breath. And then we can run up here. Come on. Whew. Let's drink our Estus. Yeah, there's a lot to loot there, but you know what I say about that? Fuck all of it. I do not want it at all. Okay. Hang on. Before we go anywhere else, let's keep moving. So, there are bloodstains, but no enemies down here. Ain't that interesting? Be wary of chests. Be wary of chests. Be wary of chests. Huh. I wonder if that's a mimic. The very first motherfucking chest they put at you is a fucking mimic. And mind you, shit kicked my ass. before we fight that thing. There's an annoying little guard here. I'm actually gonna hopefully skip fighting him the first time, because if we swing out this way, really push fast, come over here, ignore whatever the fuck is happening. If we come up to here, we should have our bonfire. Beautiful. Light it. Boom. Bonfire get. And that's gonna be this episode. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you're excited. We're gonna do a little bit of exploration of this area, figure out what's going on with this dragon, hopefully. And, well, just continue exploring Dark Souls 3. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.